Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade with another tutorial in the Coding Fundamentals in GML series. This time we're going to be talking about the basics of variables. What is a variable? A variable is a storage location somewhere in the computer's memory paired with a name that contains data. Or more simply, you can think of it as a named piece of data. Metaphorically, it's like you have a box that you write a name on and then you put data in that box. And then you can later access that data or change that data. A variable then has two parts. It has the variable name and the data. First, the requirements. The name must be made up of letters, numbers, or underscores. Letters are case sensitive, and the name must start with a letter or underscore. So it can have numbers, but it can't start with a number. These are requirements. The program won't actually compile. GameMaker Studios won't recognize the variable name if you don't follow them. Then there are also conventions. These are not required, but they're generally considered good practice. You want to try for clear and descriptive names. You want it to be readable and consistent. A good rule of thumb is if you handed your code to someone else, will they understand what your variable stood for? Now that we've talked about naming a variable, let's talk about using it. To use a variable, the first thing you have to do is set it. Many programming languages require you to initialize a variable before using it. GML does that behind the scenes. Here are some examples of setting a variable. Let's walk through it. Switch over to laser pointer here. So on the left-hand side of the equal sign, we have the variable name. You can see player name, player health, player weapon. So these are all variable names. Notice how these variable names comply with the rules stated before. On the right-hand side of the equal sign, you have the data, blink, three, sword, soap. Player name equals link, player health equals 3, player weapon equals sword. We're taking the data on the right hand side and assigning it to the variable names on the left hand side. In the middle we have this equal sign. This is the assignment operator. We'll talk more about operators in the operator tutorial, but for the moment it's important to know that the equal sign is not the same as the mathematical equal sign. It's not saying that player name is equal to link, it's saying that player name gets the value of link. We're setting this variable name with this data. Again, to use the metaphor from before, we're putting this data in the box labeled player name. As we mentioned, changing a variable is identical to setting it as far as what you type. The only difference is that behind the scenes, GameMaker will initialize it for you if it doesn't exist and change it if it does. And we'll see an example of this in a moment. Finally, we have using or referencing the data. This is as simple as referencing the variable name. So here we have show debug message. This is a function built into GameMaker Studios that prints whatever you put in parentheses to the output window. So in this case, we'd just be printing these values to the output window. If you reference a variable before you create it, you're going to crash GameMaker. GameMaker will give you an error message. And we'll cover error messages in a later tutorial, but the important part I've highlighted here. The variable player name not set before reading. So you can see that we called a function and referenced player name, but it wasn't set, and so GameMaker has simply crashed. Okay, switching over to GameMaker Studio, we have a demonstration of the things that we were just talking about. I'm going to run it here, and while it's compiling, I'm going to walk through it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to set the three variables to this data. So player name will equal link, player health will equal 3, player weapon will equal sword. We're going to print that to the output window down here. We're going to change it. We're going to print it again using the same variable names, and then the program is going to close. So if you're used to using GameMaker, you probably expect to see a window pop up. That's not going to happen. This is immediately going to run and exit, and should be done. Here we go. So link 3 sword, link 3 sword. We change it, print it again, Zelda 5 Master Sword. To see that a little bit more clearly, we're going to run it with the debugger. We're going to have a whole tutorial series on the debugger, but the important part is that the debugger allows us to step through our code line by line. When the debugger hits this breakpoint, it will stop, and now we can step through our code. So you can see player name, player health, player weapon have not been initialized. They don't exist yet. The built-in variables have been, but ours have not. However, as we go through the code, they appear down here. Now, we will print out those variables. You can see them appearing down here, link 3 sword. Over here, they're going to change as we go through the next lines. And then they're going to print out the next three variables. And then the program will end. The last thing to do now is to recreate the error from the slides. So let's remove this line here. Now, we are referencing player name before it's created. It is created down here, but this is going to happen first. So when we run it, we're going to get an error message. All right, I cut out the compiling time, and now we have the error message. This is the same error message as before. Variable, player name, not set before reading. Calling it from line 10, show debug message, player name. And over here, you can see line 10, player name is being referenced, but it hasn't been created yet. It's created down here. And this crashes the program. In summary, variables are named data, and there are rules for naming a variable. There are also conventions or best practices for naming a variable, and you must set a variable before you reference it. Here's some additional resources. The links will be below, and as always, you'll be able to get the full PowerPoint and GameMaker Studio 2 project as well. That's it. Thanks for watching.